We're going into the nastiest of the nastiest. We're going to things that people are running out of. My firefighters are going in.
When we first get there, we want to get a bird's eye view of the entire scene. Depending on what it is, it could be a swift water rescue. We might be looking for somebody in the lake or a river. Or if it's a structure fire, we're going to get above the structure fire. And we're going to probably turn our cameras to infrared.
We send anywhere from 6 to 10 fire trucks on every fire in the city. Engines, the ones that carry the water and the hose, they're going to go in and actually put the fire out. Our truck companies, the one that have the ladders, they're going to go and do search and rescue. And then my job as the incident commander is to put all that chaos and bring order to it.
The incident commander, for the most part, he's either going to be in his vehicle or he'll be on the street somewhere, but he can't see half of what we're seeing from the air.
Drone is just another set of eyes, is the best way to say it with our drone program. And we really started seeing this, like we can use this on almost every incident. So like on fires. Fires, it's really important because we get that eye in the sky view. If I'm dealing with a building that's 3-4 stories tall or even a high rise, I'm limited of what my vision is. Being able to put up another piece that gives me a really big overall view is a huge piece of the drone program, and that's how we use it.
That's been about 3 years. Start of the program, we ended up getting our first drone. We bought our vehicle and we started responding to a few incidents. Found out pretty quickly that it was gonna be a very useful tool in our arsenal for firefighting and search and rescue. We only had about 3 pilots to start that went out and got their Part 107 FAA pilot's license. And since then we've added another 7 pilots to our staff. And now we're able to operate pretty much 24/7 with the program. The biggest part of it is safety, keeping our firefighters safe. If there's anything that could be a hazard to a firefighter, we're going to see it, and our incident commander is going to see it as well.
So my job, the most important thing is I put 40 people typically at every fire in harm's way. So the men and women of the Denver Fire Department, they're running in as people are running out. And that's the most important piece of the incident commander, is to make sure that we're looking at this big picture view and that we're pulling our people out when it's appropriate or not putting them in harm's way when it's overly dangerous or more dangerous than what we want them to be in.
When we're dispatched to a scene, we set up as close to the incident commander as we can, and we get our drones in the air as quickly as we can. Basically, park the drone over the incident. From that point, we're just gonna be directed by our incident commander. He'll tell us where he wants to have the drone and what he would like to see, whether it's gonna be just a regular 4K video that we can display or infrared video.
One of the best pieces of drones, we get really good video. Obviously, it's 4K, it's the almost high definition you can get. The drones, we can put them up in high winds, and it's amazing the technology keeps that picture nice and still. But what's really amazing is they can flip a switch and they can turn on what we call flare, forward-looking infrared technology. So it's taking out, we're looking for heat signatures. So now I can take the building, instead of looking at it like we see it, and now we're looking at it for heat. So I can find out where my hotspots are. I can find out if there's hidden fire in places, or if we're looking for a victim in the water, we can find that difference in body temperature and we can see things maybe a little further down in the water. And what's really cool about the drone program and the program we use, which is called Tablet Command, in our chief's vehicles, we are able to link that. So I don't even have to get out of my vehicle. I can take that mobile. So as our drone team shows up, they've got video cameras, they've got all these things in there, TV screens. We don't have to physically go over there and see those screens. They broadcast it to my iPad and I literally have it in my hand.
We have a couple different ways of displaying video. We have our video is also down to our controller, but we also stream our video to our vehicle and a TV in our vehicle. We can also stream our video across the internet to a URL link, and we can give that to anyone who'd like to watch that's authorized to watch. Our command staff, our chief, our PIO officers, that sort of thing. Right now we've got 7 drones and 3 vehicles. We have a primary vehicle that's also a communications vehicle. We have 2 smaller vehicles that are basically our take-home vehicles for 2 of our pilots. We can respond with those vehicles 24/7 from wherever we are. All cities are pretty much getting on board with flying drones these days. We feel that we were pretty much ahead of the game when we started. We had some good people that figured out how to do this. We knew how we needed to operate, so we built this program from the ground up with our own staff.
They're amazing. They're all self-taught. They are all electronic guys, so they all are the guys that like to play with electronics and computers and different things, so it fits into their skill set. They're an amazing group. And these people are not 24-hour employees like we are. They are 5 day a week, 10-hour, 8-hour employees, and they are there at the drop of a hat if we need them. If it's the middle of the night, they get in their cars, they respond, and they'll be there.
Stay elevated by subscribing to the city's YouTube page for these stories and more. And stay tuned to our social media channels for more content. Don't miss our new episodes of Elevating Denver, premiering each month. Thanks for watching, Denver.